Hey, this is Bruce Turkell with this week's video blog. I still can't bring myself to say vlog, I'm sorry. Ironically enough though, one of the most important aspects to shooting good video like this is the audio. I've learned that viewers will put up with fuzzy shots or shaky images, but if the sound is bad or hard to hear, they'll sign off almost immediately. Because of that, I'm always fretting about how to get the best sound on my marketing mini videos that I do out on the street. I'm constantly experimenting with new microphones to hear which one works best. And because, like cameras, the best microphone is always the one you happen to have with you when you need it. So I always try to carry one of my mics with me. Depending on where I'm going, I choose from a wired lapel mic, just a regular little mic on a black wire, a big unidirectional mic with a fuzzy windscreen, which is on my camera right now, you can't see it, or my favorite, a little Bluetooth mic called Hey Mic. It's only about this big and it clips right onto my lapel. But sometimes I'll be out somewhere and I'll come up with the perfect marketing minute idea when I don't have a mic with me at all. And then I have to settle for using Apple's white earbuds to make sure that the video sounds as good as possible. And I'm always concerned that with these white lumps of plastic in my ears and the white wires running down the side of my face, people will find it distracting. But you know what? No one seems to care. Nobody has ever commented or criticized the unprofessionalism of that approach. Of course, people criticize what I have to say and they disagree with my conclusions, but they may never mention the wires. When I was in high school, our marching band played at the Star Spangled Banner at Disney World, right smack in the middle of the Magic Kingdom. But when we first got to the park, we didn't lug our instruments down Main Street. Instead, we got out of the buses and we were hustled into a tunnel and walked underneath the Magic Kingdom all the way to Cinderella's castle. That's where we magically appeared in front of the audience we entertained. Everything above the ground was seamless and perfect in Disney's special way. But underneath the park, the Magic Kingdom was just a little less magic. We saw the people who played the Disney characters on their breaks. They took off their giant cartoon heads to better slurp their sodas and smoke their cigarettes. This was in the 70s, by the way, when people did that. We saw seamstresses repairing costumes. We saw electricians fixing wiring. And we saw the sanitation workers lugging bins and bins of garbage out to the giant dumpsters hidden in the back. We saw all of this because we were working there. But the paying guests didn't see any of this. They just enjoyed a seamless experience where everything was impossibly perfect. So think about the things you used to do that are just about impossible now. Maybe your scrupulously touched up roots are peeking through in all their gray glory. Perhaps your regularly trimmed hair is now unruly and shaggy like mine is. Maybe you haven't been to the gym as often or even at all. Maybe you haven't been to the dry cleaners, the hardware store, or the bank. Maybe online homeschooling is a little less educational and a little more raucous than you expected. Maybe you're tired of beans and rice for the fourth night in a row. But like the teeming tunnels under Disney World or the white wires peeking out of my ears on my marketing minutes, sometimes seamlessness just isn't possible. Or maybe even necessary. You'll see that on Saturday Night Live's home broadcasts. You'll see that when you watch your favorite musician host an online concert. You'll experience that when your home delivery grocery service brings the wrong things, or maybe your next day Amazon delivery takes a few more days than usual. That doesn't mean that the experience or the content of what you're doing isn't valuable. It just means that perhaps it's a little too hard to keep everything as perfect as usual. For years, I've said that people don't choose what you do, they choose who you are. Today's coronavirus new normal is proving that to be truer than ever. If you're truly sharing your knowledge and your talents and a bit of who you are, then your shaggy gray locks or your small mistakes are just a little more of who you are. And in a time when people are desperate for certainty, the certainty of who you are is exactly what your audience wants and appreciates.